the cartridges for the Enfield rifled musket were packed 10 at a time inside a sturdy brown paper wrapper. There was further packaging inside the packet, consisting of a strip of paper meant to separate the individual cartridges. To package my ammunition, I used the following: a wrapper forming block, a wrapper support block, and a cartridge bundle forming jig. The wrapper forming block measures 3 inches in width, 1.25 inches in height, and somewhere between 5 and 6 inches in length. The support block is sized to loosely contain the forming block and is somewhere around 2 inches deep. The cartridge jig measures 3 inches between the uprights. The packet wrapper measures 4.5 inches by 8.5 inches and has a printed label centered. With the label portion of the wrapper facing down, join the two ends with a piece of tape. Next, fold the end over as though wrapping a present. Then, insert the forming block into the supporting block with the paper attached, and then remove the forming block, leaving the wrapper in the support block. Lay a piece of waxed paper 3 inches by 24 inches over the forming jig, with the midpoint just off to one side. Starting on the short side, lay the cartridges down, alternating directions, while weaving the wax strip from the short side only between the rounds as to separate them. Continue back across the jig with the second layer of cartridges. Once this is done, bring both tails of the waxed strip back over the top. With a quick flip into the palm, the bundle is thus formed. Wrapping the tails around the bundle, insert it into the support block and the empty wrapper. Fold the wrapper like a present and secure it with tape. Sometimes it's easier to see the process in action rather than just in still pictures. With our 24-inch strip of waxed paper, we lay it across the jig with the center point offset to one side. We then lay our cartridges down, alternating their direction, and weaving the short side of the strip between them as to maintain separation. Once we've completed the first row, we work our way back across, ensuring that we maintain our differing directions of the cartridges, but using the same technique of weaving the waxed strip between rounds. Once this is done, we take the tail of the waxed strip and bring it across the top of the bundle, tensioning it slightly. Then, flipping the jig over into the palm of the hand, release the bundle. Once the bundle is out, we wrap the remaining tail of the waxed strip around the bundle. Now, this process here looks a little bit awkward, but I can assure you with practice, it becomes smooth and effortless. We then take the bundle and insert it into the wrapper, which is being held by the support block. The tolerances here are quite small, so a bit of practice is required so that parts of the cartridge or of the waxed paper strip don't get caught up on the wrapper during insertion. It will be necessary at this time to push down on the 5 upside down cartridges to make sure that they are all at the same level to make it easy then to form the end of the wrapper in the form of a present. We secure the end with a little bit of tape, and we are ready for the next step, which is the application of the string. The method that I use to tie off the cartridge packet isn't necessarily historical, much like the rest of the evolution, but enables you to withdraw the packet from the ammunition pouch with ease. By taking a 14-inch piece of string, doubling it up and tying a knot in the end, then looping it around the cartridge packet, the tying off is complete. Once tied off, the cartridge packet is ready for insertion into the cartridge pouch, and with the string, is readily removable.